Hi, and welcome in Serbia on this crazy hot day. This is madness, really, here. I'm all wet. It was 35 degrees today. It's hell, really. But nevertheless, we're going to do a video again. In this video, I'm going to show you one more way how to check your potential issues with your car, with the electronics, what's wrong. You know that I made that video about the OBD1 scanner and how you can do that with impulses when you turn the ignition on and you stick a wire or this OBD1 scanner on your diagnostic socket by the firewall at the right fender near the battery. And this is another way. This way you will be doing a bit different. So how? Let's see that right now. In this video, I'm going to show you how to diagnose what's wrong on your car using another method. You know that video I was talking about when you have to do that diagnosing on the X11 4 port socket there that is located by the battery on your right fender. And now, this is the second method that we're going to use to discover what's wrong with our car and what's the potential cause of your malfunctioning. For the first method, I'll post your link here above so you can see that video. And for this test, you need exclusively, and I repeat, exclusively a multimeter that can measure percents, that can do duty cycle. Here. When I choose it here, now it measures percents. Exclusively that. I'm going to do one more video about the duty cycle before I manage to do that on my car, because I haven't managed to do it yet the proper way. There are some minor issues I have on my car and I cannot do that. And there on my Facebook page, I'm going to let you know how you can do that using a common multimeter. There is another way, but for this way, the only, and I repeat now, seriously, the only possible way to do that is by using percents, by using duty cycle capable multimeter. And that is done on the X11 round socket. Here. For those that watch my videos for the first time, this is a X11, the round socket. So here, as you can see, we have here port 1, 2, 3. So you have to stick your multimeter in the ports 2 and 3. This is for the negative, and this is for the positive. That's it. And the engine must be pre-warmed at the operating temperature. That's the only thing. The goal of this test is for you to get 50%. For you that don't have a lambda probe, you have to get 50% steady reading. And for us that have a lambda probe, we have to get this fluctuation. Now, in contrast to that test I was talking about the OBD1 scanner, this is not done with the key in, ignition on, and that's it. For this test, you will have to pre-warm your car. So your car must be at the operating temperature. And you stick your multimeter leads in contacts 2 and 3. And if you get anything else than 50%, as I've mentioned, then it's something is wrong. In order to see what's wrong, then I will put you the table here and you can see if you read, for example, 10%, something is wrong. Then 40%, 70%, 80%, 100%. What does it mean? You will see that in this label here. And one more thing, for all of you that don't have a port number 3 on the X11 socket, well, you cannot do this test, unfortunately. So, my dear ones, if you enjoyed this video, then please don't click the button skip ad. It is going to help me a lot. And till the next video, happy Mercedesing! Bye.